Keyframing? Light and dark mode? What about motion tracking? Yep, the new Filmora X is here, ready for you to download, and it is a powerhouse of features that every one of us has been asking for a while. If you want to learn how to find and use all these new features in Filmora 10, stick around. I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
This video is sponsored by the good people of Filmora. It's like we put the band back together. Let's get right into it.
One of the first things you're going to notice is that Wondershare Filmora X feels very similar to the previous version of Filmora, so you'll feel right at home using the new update. Let's jump right in with one of the coolest features, keyframing. Bring a piece of footage down into your timeline, and when you left-click on it in the upper left, you'll see under the Animation tab that you now have the options for Preset and Customize. The Customize tab is where all the cool keyframing features exist. Now, there's a lot of different ways to use this, but let me show you some of the basic functions. Here we just have a piece of footage of a surfer that's surfing out on the ocean. The footage is full screen and it's not doing anything. Let's go back to the beginning of the footage, and I'm going to add a keyframe by clicking on the Add button in the upper left. If you look at the footage down in your timeline, you'll see that a little green dot has been added right where the playhead was. That's important because it gives us a starting point to tell Filmora this piece of footage should be full frame at this scale with no opacity changes, just as it looks right here. But maybe as we move forward, we decide to change it a bit. Let's go back to the upper left and click Add Another Keyframe, and you'll see another keyframe is added. But now we can left-click on the footage in our timeline to highlight it up in our preview window and make some changes. Let's shrink this down to the corner. You'll notice a green arrow appears from keyframe to keyframe, telling us that there's going to be a change between these two keyframes. Let's go back and take a quick peek. I'll hit play and watch what happens. Now that footage just dives down into the corner, Filmora fills in all of the blanks of what should happen with that piece of footage between the first keyframe and the second keyframe, from full screen to where we shrunk it down. Now let's say we want to do something different from here. Let's add another keyframe that will hold it at this position between these two keyframes. Let's play the footage a bit forward, and let's add one more keyframe here. Now let's left click to highlight that up in our timeline, and let's move that way up into the right. While we're at it, let's go into the upper left and let's rotate that footage, and let's dial the opacity back to non-existent. Now what you'll see happens is this piece of footage goes from being shrunk down in the lower left corner to spinning up and slowly dissipating as it goes up to the right. This gives you all kinds of control over what you want your footage to do in your preview window for animation. You can see there's a back button that will take you to the previous keyframes, or forward that will take you to the one ahead of it. If you want to delete any of those keyframes at that point, just click Delete. This is a feature that Filmora users have been waiting a long time for. But wait, there's more! Let me show you the color match feature. Here I have two different pieces of footage of two different surfers surfing. One with this really warm, bright, sunny coloration to it, and the other one that's more blue with the sun in a completely different location and a totally different coloration to it. If I right-click on the second piece of footage in my timeline and choose Color Match, what it will do in the upper right preview window is give me my entire timeline of footage to choose from. I'm gonna scroll back to the very first piece of footage that had that really bright, warm yellow sun look to it. I'm going to choose the Match button, and now Filmora will take the coloration from that piece of footage and match it into my second piece of footage. Now I can dial back the amount of coloration I want added in so there's virtually none, or temper it in to get a little bit of that feel. Once I've got it where I like it, I just click OK, and now my footage has been color matched to approximate the look of the other footage I've chosen. Let me show you another cool thing that Filmora X can do. I'm a huge fan of using keyboard shortcuts, but if you go up to the upper left, click on File, and scroll down to Keyboard Shortcuts, you'll now see an entire list of all the different shortcuts that are available to you in Filmora X, with all of the shortcuts listed next to what each one does. But wait, it doesn't stop there. Some of these shortcuts I use all the time, such as Split, which on my keyboard is always Control plus B. but I can back out of that and decide I don't want to click that many keys and just say, hey, I'd rather just click the B button and have that split my footage. I click OK, and now wherever my playhead is in my timeline, if I hit B on my keyboard, it automatically creates a split. You can now customize all of your keyboard shortcuts to whatever you want them to be. But let me show you another cool feature, audio ducking. Now, I've got a few pieces of footage here, one where I'm talking, and then one where I'm waving my hand around that has no audio on it whatsoever, and then one where I start talking again. I've got an audio bed under that that's all playing at one volume. Now, in other versions, if I started talking, I would add audio keyframes to reduce the level of my background music so that it didn't overpower the areas where I started speaking. But here's something really cool you can do. Let's double left click on this piece of footage in the timeline, go up to the audio tab, and scroll down to ducking. You'll see it says lower the volume of the other clips. If we tick that box, we can now decide how much we want to lower the volume of the other clips. And if you look down below, Filmora has reduced the volume of that section and then slowly faded it back up where there was an area where I wasn't speaking. If I click OK, it will apply that change. Let's say we want this to actually reduce back down in volume on the second clip where I start speaking again. Let's double left click on that in my timeline, and in the audio tab above, let's apply that same ducking feature, and it will pull that audio back to a level that we want it to go down to. Click OK, and now we have that entire section laid out quickly so that the background music ducks down when I'm speaking and raises back up when I'm not. But wait, I have saved the best feature for last. One feature that Filmora users have been asking for forever, and that's motion tracking. This motion tracking feature is actually really good. I've got some footage of myself waving my hand around. Let me go to the very beginning of that footage. I'm going to double left click on it in my timeline, and in the upper left under the video tab, I'm gonna open up the motion tracking feature. Let me tick that box, and you'll see that in the upper right preview window, a motion tracking feature box has been added. Now I can click on that and move it exactly where I want. I'm going to put it in the center of the palm of my hand and shrink it down a little bit. And once I got it where I want it, located on my hand, in the upper left, I'm gonna tell Filmora X, start tracking. Filmora now automatically tracks and assigns that motion to the clip by itself. Now the second step in that process is you have to assign what you want to be tracked. In this case, I've got a piece of text that says yes. I'm going to put that right up in the center of my palm, and in the motion tracking box of the footage below, in the drop-down menu, anything that's aligned with this track in this portion of my timeline will show up in the drop-down menu. Now I could either import something and put it here, or use the default title that I've already created. Let's just choose that title. And that yes now follows my hand perfectly. Now you can download the latest version of Filmora 10 right from the help tab of Filmora 9, or you can click on the link that I'll put down below to download it today. Oh, and before I forget, if you want to use Filmora in either a light mode or dark mode, go up to the File menu, scroll down to Preferences, and in the General tab, you'll see Appearance. This will allow you to switch Filmora X from dark mode back into light mode if you're one of those people who miss the old school look of Filmora and don't like working in the dark. If you want to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques, make sure you click on the video that's on screen now or the ones I'll pin down below. Say it with me. Peace.